nation now. Vadam and Eve, they rocks been a mystic and conspiracy of love. From the Father up above, Satan's on the loose, he's trying to deceive anyone who would believe in this great mystery of love. From Zion up above.
Love of my Savior. white stripes, we are healed. If you search through the scriptures, then you will find the mysteries of the prophets revealed. It is you.
I am. It's who I am.
You alone are my only refuge in a storm.
vision that out of many gods there was just one. So when the missionaries had arrived, they told them about Jesus Christ.
Like royalty, the missionaries were received, and the queen was the first to believe. The third Kamehameha's declaration, this would be the greatest Christian nation. Of this song I sing, I've never known another thing like this joy he brings. It's all about the Father. Of this song I sing, yes, the crystal diamante one, the ever living King,
the ever living King.
Thank you.
with all of my soul. I won't forget the good things you have done. With great joy, you made me whole. I'm counting every blessing.
So good, you make me.
you are holy, you are worthy. If you are the King of all kings, really and truly, I am devoted to you. Really and truly, there is none greater than you. Because you are love supreme, love supreme. You are love supreme. You are my king.
Who has the name of
without sin.
Without sin.
We'll fall on our faces and worship Him, the King of Kings. He is the keeper of salvation, the one enthroned, the great I am. Let every tribe and every nation worship Him, singing worthy is the Lamb. Yes, He reigns. He reigns. He reigns. Yes, He reigns.
Treasure is, there is your heart.
depths of the sea. There is no place I'd rather be. Darkest time in my life, but I loved reggae and I loved to sing songs about Jehovah. I was open to the Bible to an extent, but I just didn't vibe with the church, and I definitely didn't like Christians. They seemed so fake with their happy, happy, joy, joy songs, their plastic smiles. To be honest, I just didn't get it because I knew what was best for me. Or at least I thought I did. Until I met this cool guy named Marcus. He was so much like me, and we connected as we shared stories about his drug past and my drug present. But the more that I got to know him, the more I realized that though we had so much in common in the past, our lives were headed in two entirely different directions. You see, mine was a dead-end street, but his had a future and a hope. I just couldn't put my finger on it. So one day I asked him, what's the difference between you and I? I'll never forget his response. He said four simple words that would forever change the trajectory of my life. The love of God, he replied. He had found what I had been missing. He had received God's love, his grace, his forgiveness, and he was forever transformed by it.
It's hard to explain, but that simple answer regarding the hope that he had within literally sparked a revolution within me. And just 2 weeks later, after truly surrendering my life to Christ, I started Christafari, and I'd never be the same again, forever changed by the love of Jah.
What is the difference between me and you? What is the difference between me and you? The love of Jah. The love of Jah. I do not deserve your love, and I could never earn your grace. You sent your son from Zion above, your only son to take my place. And I cannot imagine the pain he suffered again and again, the torture, the scorn and the shame, so he could take all of my blame. The love, the love, the love, the love of Jah. The love, the love, the love, the love of Jah. The love, the love, the love, the love of Jah. The love, the love, the love, the love of Jah. What is the difference between me and you?